fresh out of the garden, green tomato, pepper,
onion,
honey,
coconut oil,
and coconut oil. Green tomato salsa. Oh man, is that good. Oh, those peppers, I got my nose opened up too. There's a little, the long cayenne pepper, or not jalapeno.
No, they're not
jalapeno. Cayenne pepper, I believe. I should have got the video before when my wife was making them. Oh, but this is all out of our garden. The only thing that's not out of our garden is the onion, you know, which again, we're just going to start growing those this year. So, out of our garden, this you can taste everything. I taste the tomato, I taste the onion, of course, I taste the honey, I taste the coconut. Oh, man. My nose is running from that pepper because it would be like a medium. It's not hot, it's not mild, it's medium. It'll open up your nose. This is good. We're gonna put it in the refrigerator and get all the juices in there. Oh man, that's some major good hot salsa, homemade. Oh, look at this garden out here. Oh. And here I go with diarrhea of the mouth. Mm-hmm. I pulled up the two of the pumpkin plants that were really bad and disposed of them. I mean, oh, come on. See, this is live. Almost live. That's why I should have Ozymandias 03 almost live, because I don't stop. I can't pause this while I'm recording. At least I don't know how to do it on this camera. I pulled up two or three of the pumpkins. They were intertwined into my torch sunflowers. And while I was doing that, see how the torch sunflowers are pulled over on top of the pumpkin. There's like two plants out there now, which is okay. We'll let that go. Purple pole beans right here, right next to the hummingbird feeder there. Let me see if I can zoom in. I'm gonna get the dirt on the window. Oh gosh, a crack on this damn shirt. There, okay, right there. In the middle there is a purple pole with that white canister jar for chlorine tablets, which I've watered. I put my hornworms that I get off tomato plants if I find any. The big tomato plant on the right is one that I grew inside here, and the one behind it is almost the same size. That was from inside here, and then there are four right next to them from Kmart, of which the third one back looks like crap. But we've had problems with hornworms on all those tomato plants. I've probably got about eight hornworms all total off. But it was primarily on the Kmart ones first. Okra is putting out like crazy. We're going out there twice a day. But see, there's so many that are right at the almost, that get a little bit bigger, so we're just trying to do it once a day. We get a whole bunch. Purple pole beans in the back again. Cucumber, we have eight of them out there. We're only going to do three next year. Then we got honeydew and cantaloupe over there, which I got two over here real quick. Here. Purple hull peas, black-eyed peas, zucchini, cucumbers. These are okra we're letting go to seed. Purple pole peas we're going to let go to seed. Let them dry out. A few little. Big cantaloupes, man. Oh, I just ate one. Oh God, they're good. I got about 4 pounds of black-eyed peas so far. And then the last rows over there is black-eyed peas and the purple hull peas on the end. And I just pulled out in a pod out in the garden about 2 weeks ago. And one of the purple hull peas was not, you know, dried out really or anything. I just went ahead and put four of them down in the ground. Guess what? I got four purple hull peas growing out there too now in the back. And the far end. And then the squash up front here, the four squash are growing really good. And I got Jackson Wonder Beans out there, two Wonder Bean plants growing. So, that's salsa right here. We're gonna put in the refrigerator now. Let it cool off. Man, that's gonna be some good salsa. All from the garden, other than the onion, which I wanna get onion in there. But everything's fresh right out of the garden. I know where it came from. It's all heirloom, so it's not genetically modified. Because the House of Representatives just voted down for states to be able to know that if their food is genetically modified or not. You think they really care about you? Because if you do, you really, really, really are stupid. If you don't grow your own food, you don't know where it comes from, and they're gonna make sure of that right now. So I imagine in the next year, they're gonna start saying something about people having gardens. I'm almost expecting to have the cops come out here and stop and come on my private property to tell me I can't do this. And that ain't gonna happen, so. Anyway, grow your own food so you know where it's coming from. I would suggest, again, Heirloom Solutions, which is where I get my seeds for heirloom vegetables. They're difficult because you can't put pesticides and stuff on them. You use baking soda and water for like diseases, and then soap, just regular like ivory. I use ivory soap with a gallon of water, let half a third of a bar dissipate in there overnight, and spray it out there. It does a really good job, and you can add more water to it, but no chemicals. So anyway, there you go, homemade salsa. Yeah, one more time. I've eaten a bunch of that, and my wife's had some. It's hot. It's medium. It's really good. Okay, that's all.